If you're recording something long, like an audiobook, say, you're going to make mistakes sometimes. Stumble over a word, pronounce something wrong, maybe you cough or sneeze, or maybe it's just a noise in the background. What do you do? One popular way of dealing with this is called punch and roll recording. Before I talk about why it's called that, let me show you what punch and roll recording looks like. By the way, most recording software has this functionality built in, including Adobe Audition and Reaper. So I'm narrating an audiobook. Left Munich at 8:35 p.m. on 1st May, arriving in Vienna early next morning. Should have arrived at 6:46, but train was an hour late. Budapest seems a wonderful place. So punch and roll is telling the program that you want to start recording at a very specific time marker in the audio, and it's going to give you a little bit of a runway so you can listen to what you already recorded for a few seconds and jump back into, so you sort of read along with yourself with the recording, and then it's going to start recording automatically where you told it to and replace everything. Let me just show you. In Audacity, the keyboard shortcut for punch and roll is Shift D. So you put the cursor right where you sort of put this marker right before the mistake, or right before the phrase that has the mistake in it. So this is where the mistake happened. From the glimpse which I got of, so I want to pick up and start recording again right there. So I'm going to leave that there, and then I'm going to hit Shift D and watch what happens. But train was an hour late. Budapest seems a wonderful place, from the glimpse which I got of it from the train and the little I could walk through the streets. So it automatically started recording right at the point where I had this line, and it also erased the stuff that came after that line and replaced it with the new recording. And then you just keep recording until you make the next mistake, and then you do it again. So what is the advantage of doing it this way? By correcting mistakes as you go, your finished product will be free of errors. If you don't want to do a lot of editing after the fact, this is a good method. It also keeps things simple. Everything is still all on one track. Other methods involve creating new tracks for new audio and complicates everything. But there are some disadvantages. The most obvious one is that you can't get into a flow because you have to stop and start over and over. That can lead to differences in the sound of new takes if you changed positions in relation to the microphone, or if you were louder or the emotion was different. Any number of things can change the way you sound from the previous recording. I promised earlier that I'd explain why this method is called punch and roll. This goes back to the tape recorder days. When the tape was rolling, it often meant that it was recording. And one common way to deal with mistakes was called punching in and punching out, which was usually done after one complete take of the song. You'd already finished recording the song. If you just wanted to fix one short thing, it didn't make sense to record the entire song again, so you just record over a certain word or phrase. The engineer would hit the record button at a certain point while you sang over that spot on the tape. Then they would turn the record button off when you'd finished, which was referred to as punching out. So punch and roll just means having the program, you don't need an engineer to do this manually anymore, punch in to start recording at a specific spot that you choose. Then, because you just continue on narrating or singing or whatever, the tape continues to roll. So punch to start recording and roll to continue recording. So now you know. Impress your friends. There are several other ways to deal with mistakes when recording, and I will do videos for each of them.